our park became a park after the elephant seals came. So elephant seals weren't historically in this area. We had grizzly bears, they would have been eaten. So actually once our lighthouse station, the island, was abandoned in the 40s, about 10 years after that, the seals started coming into the island. And then about 1965 or so, they started to come to the land here at Año Nuevo. So the park formed around them because there was a need once they arrived that people weren't behaving properly. So we built the park around them. So the park's been around since the 1960s. We still have this historic dairy complex. This land here has gone through a lot of different iterations. It was dairy, it was cattle. There was a adobe here back in the day. So it's seen a lot of history here in this park, but the elephant seals since the 1960s have been the main draw for being here. We were one of the first mainland colonies of the elephant seal. Before that, they mostly just bred on islands because there was large predators on land here. Now there's not, so they're happy on land. What you guys saw today is you were taken into our preserve. The preserve is there to protect the seals. It's completely hands-off, so if anything happens, life, death, all of those things, we do not interfere unless it's a man-made issue. So if someone comes to shore with like fishing line or something like that, then we step in and help out the seals. Otherwise, it's just a natural processes, and you don't see that a lot anymore. So I think that makes it even more special. It's full on wilderness. It's like being on a safari, and we try and keep it as pristine and special as we can.